Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm showing you a video of a combination treatment. Now, this was requested by one of our subscribers in Europe, a physician, and they were wondering, can you combine Sculptra and the PDO threads? And we do this commonly. We'll show you the video today with a before and after picture also at the end. I chose a combination treatment too because it's what we do in practice. People often ask, can you combine treatments? Is it good to combine treatments? And yesterday we had a patient come in who had a nasojugal groove, so a groove along the face that was a hollow. Had been to a couple other clinics and they recommended a skin tightening device, and the patient didn't want to do filler, so that suited them. And they came here to see if they could get skin tightening here. And typically those procedures run anywhere from $2,000 to $5,000, so it's fairly expensive. And you just can't fill or tighten the skin enough to get rid of a hollow like that with skin tightening alone. So my answer is no. Now that patient will go somewhere and they'll collect the $3,000 to $5,000, and they won't really be happy with that procedure. You need to use filler, and if filler doesn't appeal to you, you could use fat transfer, a little more cumbersome. You have to take the fat, spin it down, put it back. So I wanted to talk about combination procedures so that people understand that these procedures we do often work in concert together. It's not one or the other. And if you have a specific problem, it's good to get a couple consults like that patient did. But understand that oftentimes we have to turn patients away. Patients don't like that. But a lot of us offer free consults just because of that. We're always trying to predict based on our experience, and as predictable as these products and procedures are, it's the human body. We can never be perfect. And if you're about 80 to 90% correct each time, that's a very high percentage. So 10 to 20% of the time, we're going to need adjunct treatments or more than what we estimated to start with. It's just the nature of the beast. So this combination treatment, it's a little longer video today. I'll start, we'll talk as we do the procedure, but we're combining, it's kind of like a mini liquid lift, Botox, Sculptra, and the PDO thread. So I hope you enjoy. So here we're doing the Botox. When we're doing the forehead, and of course, treating the forehead with Botox or neuromodulators never creates lift. We got to keep that in mind. The only thing we can do is lower the brow. So in this case, there's diffuse lines. We're using low dose in several areas, and we don't want to create a Spock brow. Pressure, if you see a little area that might bruise or a little area of bleeding, is the best. Now, this is still our most common area to treat with Botox, the frown area. This will create a lift because we're stopping the movement of depressor muscles. And that's the key here. Now we move to the eyes, and we're going to do a brow lift by getting these downward fibers of the orbicularis oculi muscle. And then we're gonna come down. If you go below the lid, it's good to do a snap test, make sure there's enough collagen so that you don't get lag of the eye. And also keep in mind, when you go just below the eye, you're gonna create more of an open eye look because you're gonna get that palpebral muscle in the inferior part. Now, we're doing vertical lip lines. Nobody wants vertical lip lines. So using neuromodulators is one step. It's very cost effective in preventing these lines. People often ask about teaching, and here we're doing Sculptra. We're doing the temples, and we're going to come down and do the high cheek. It's really impossible to teach this over a video. These videos are not meant to be instructional as much as to give you concepts of what we're doing. With Sculptra, we use different dilutions for different areas of the face and body because we do treat cellulite as well. And we're at different layers, and it's so important. And here we're doing the high cheek, but keeping in mind that just in this area alone, we have the transverse facial artery, you have the facial nerve, you got your parotid gland and parotid duct. That's just one area of the face. So there's no way to teach this over a video. We're just getting concepts. We have over 3,000 subscribers now. We have anything from doctors to we have CEOs of companies, just patients wanting to get information. This preauricular area that we're injecting is extremely important. It gives a vectoring pull at the lower edge of the mouth. And often for patients, especially if they're thin, there's a hollow here, and it allows us gain to get a great result by naturally lifting. Note that the Sculptra we've used so far is all not in the mid face, but in the posterior portion of the face or above the brow and the temple. Now we're doing a thread lift here. This is a 2.5 inch barb thread, and this is 2.5 inches in length. And again, the depth, the plane that we're using is ultimately so important, because you want to avoid important structures such as that parotid duct or the parotid gland. You can see how far down the needle is, right at the edge of the mouth. That's so important because that's the area we're going to lift with the barbs. And now we're pulling it up. You can see the transformation in this patient just as we're doing these procedures here. She's getting a cheek, she has a lifted, raised brow because of that sculptor in the temples, and then the thread is going to further work to lift the edge of the mouth, lift the cheek region, and look at that jawline. We've created a beautiful, strong jawline just a result of everything else. Now here we have a 27 gauge needle with a thread, a 27 2.5 inch smooth thread. I put the barb above it, and now a smooth thread is going to build collagen in this upward vector at this lower facial region. So there we're combining a smooth and the barb thread all to get that lower lift and collagen and beautiful jawline. Now I just put side-by-side pictures just from our treatment. This is just from in between the treatment session, so you can see the before on the left and the after on the right. You can see the transformation taking place before your eyes. And here is the after picture, just a more open eye, a rested look. The area around the mouth is much better. Remember, we didn't directly inject anything around the mouth region. So there's a common combination treatment that we do in clinic. We also like sublative microneedling and PRP, adding that to the mix, especially around the eyes, all to get that skin quality better. Join us on this YouTube channel. If you've liked the video, click like, subscribe for further tips, and join us on Facebook to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.